smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your ton, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Keeping it together, Bree.
So, have you heard any news?
I'm all right, as long as
nothing
I don't think about it too
We've
much.
We've woken her everywhere.
Thanks you're safe among friends. Never us. Forget it.
Yes, of course.
How are you holding up?
Not in any mood to talk about it.
Good for you.
The carved figure is of your touch, creates a...
Keep talking,
Paul,
for you led that bit of sawdust from a cell floor.
You're safe among friends.
Thank you. This must be the wreck of the Peacemaker. Some of her cargo may remain.
The spirit hovers before you. It looks into your eyes and reaches out a hand of smoke and gossamer, silently begging. You feel the boards creak under your boots. The smell of salt and pitch fills your nose. You check the knots securing your cargo. There's a shout from above decks, and then the world turns upside down. You're pitched violently sideways as the planks around you rip apart and black water floods in. You kick and thrash, desperately trying to reach the door to the deck above, but the current hurls you back, dashing you against boxes and broken planks. As your vision fades to black, you see the walls shudder as the Peacemaker snaps. You awake to the flicker of torchlight and the sound of voices. Here, crack this in open. With locks like these, there'll be something good inside. You hear the snap of a latch being broken and a long, low whistle.
Get word to Lohar. The Reds are shipping death fog.
Send your fastest runner.
Go!
You lie still for a minute until you feel a rough kick to the ribs. Thought I saw a twitch, says the dwarf, looming over you. Well now, ain't you an unfortunate little flounder? She growls before clamping her hand across your mouth and nose. Sorry, hun, no witnesses allowed. You kick and struggle weakly, desperately trying to catch a breath, but the dwarf's grip. As your vision starts to swim, you see other dwarves moving in the torchlight, hauling your cargo off the ship. You give one last kick and then darkness. Stepping back from the spirit, the feeling of her panic starts to slowly fade from your mind. The spirit hovers before you. It looks at you, feel the ball. There's a shout from above decks, and then the current twists as your vision. You awake to the flicker of, you hear the snap of a latch being broke. There's quick movement behind you. Well, now you kick and as your vision starts stepping back from the.
Yeah? You're good with the magisters caging anyone up that looks at them funny.
Damn right. Is the great good?
I don't think you know even a small bit on the arse.
She babbles breathlessly on. Barely.
The bell rings a warning and the tide is on the turn. And I without my compass.
She babbles breathlessly on.
The bell rings a warning and the tide is on the turn. And I without my compass.
Curiosity kills the cat or gets it sent to Fort Joy.
She babbles breathlessly.
The bell rings a warning and the tide is on the turn. And I without my compass.
Then you're an idiot.
She babbles breath.
The bell rings a warning and the tide is on the turn. And I without my compass.
You're willing to risk Fort Joy for one night with a lizard. Trust. can see a sorcerer from a mile away. And you can't be too careful, you know? If they can get Alexander, they can get any of us.
You're right about that.
Who rings
right
the bell?
Right as rain, Hilga.
You're willing to... Then you're an idiot.
Hard port. Can't you hear the bells are ringing? Take the wheel, Captain. Take the wheel.
A ghostly seaman stares at the captain, his lip curled in a malevolent grin, his eyes wide with hate, and all the time he rings his bell. He registers your presence. His head swivels to...
Spoke to the lady captain, didn't you? I seen you cozying up. Are you her man, or sail you with us? Then you won't sail with her. She ran the ship upon the rocks, although I rang the bell. That light weren't no lighthouse. I rang the bell in warning. You ran the ship upon the rocks, Captain, and all the crew were drowned. I'm doing my duty here, I am. I'm the lookout, and I'm ringing the bell. Rocks ahead, Captain. But I'm on duty here. There are rocks ahead, and the captain must know it.
He blinks once, twice. A single salty tear drips from one ghostly eye. The bell falls silent. He raises a finger to his temple in salute and fades away.
Curiosity kills the cat, or gets its scent of
She babbles George. Breathlessly on, barely...
My ears are still a-ringing. And I have you to thank for it? Then thank you, I sure... That accursed bell lies with the peacemaker on the bottom in the rocky shallows. My compass lies there too. The compass surely lies on the bottom, near where the ship was wrecked. Take it with my blessing, if you can find it. My sailing days are done.
She goes white as the proverbial ghost.
You've got no call to go looking for no cargo. Far as anyone's concerned, we sailed with an empty hold, and if there's anything left to salvage, you leave it. Heed me. Leave the cargo of the peace...
She turns away. Conversation over.
You're right about that.
You're willing to risk poor joy for one night with a lizard. Then you're an idiot.
She babbles breathlessly on, barely a...
My ears are still a-ring. That accursed bell lies with the peacemaker on the bottom in the rocky shallows. The compass surely lies on the bottom, near where the ship was wrecked. Let me mark your chart. But you be warned.
She goes white.
You've got no... Heed me.
She turns away.
You've got to pick who you can trust.
You got that right, Hilga. You got that right.
And I'm saying, you can trust me. I can see a sorcerer from a mile away. And you can't be too careful, you know?
The animals argue.
Dog.
Oh.
Dog.
Can't win, can I?
The animals argue on.
Dog.
Oh.
Dog.
Oh, you're in.
You're not trying to escape, are you?
Paladin Hardwin's whistle like the The masked creature grunts three times at the sight of you. It reaches its arm out. Clasped in its hand is a crumpled parchment. You take the page, and the servant returns to its hollow existence. As you approach, the salamander turns its head away, twisting its snout into the air. The salamander's tongue flickers, tasting you on the air. It turns towards you, letting out a long, low rumble, followed by a series of hisses and chattering clicks. The lizard takes a step towards you, and its chattering grows louder. You feel like it's trying to tell you. As you approach, the salamander turns its head away.
causes with Source here.
I trust that our bargain reaches a satisfactory conclusion. Oh, that. A trivial detail. An old agreement long forgotten by all involved.
Riker's mouth widens into a tight smile.
Well, see that you find me.
Flesh and bone, severed and stitched. A rather sordid brand of necromancy. No keyhole, no handle. There must be a hidden mechanism.
Back again, eh? Looking for anything in particular? Have it your way.
Back for a return visit, are you?
Yep.
Your fish stinks of
food. I bet they're eating golden roe and high hog in the ancient empire right now.
Together,
glad to see you well.
Rations.
later, then.
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
Devours the corpses as a vulture devours carrion, stopping only as you approach.
I have my freedom. You have your reward.
He drained me.
Let me feed. Oh, I cannot control the hunger. Mordus, rip away his hide. And he's a mere... My source was his lifeblood. Now, my hunger must... My soul jar waits in the hills. Each taste of living source is like a healing salve. When I am full, I can finally open the reliquary that holds it.
The creature continues its banquet. Blood spurts spray... The beast gorges on its meal. A sleuth of bears would make less of a bloody mess.
Well, look at you, all noble. I can't promise that your sacrifice will fill my belly.
But... It reaches out with its brittle fingers, and you hesitantly offer your hand. In an instant that feels like an eon, your source flows...
Oh, refreshed and refilled. Oh, you won't need to...
You have found the little corpse-related book I seek yet? Splendid! My thanks for your help. Perhaps we will meet again in the Hall of Echoes someday. I'm just going to find a place to rest. A place where I can be how I am supposed to be.
Magisters.
Your powers of observation astonish.
The creature rubs its clattering hands together.
It's about time. My soul rests inside the reliquary. I need but a drop of your blood to open it. The fount requires a fresh offering. I upheld my part of the bargain and kept my teeth out of your so-called in. I am me. I am whole. I am Zash!
See an elf burning the body of kin.
A man paces back and forth, puffing anxiously on a pipe. His face is creased with tiredness. The faint coppery hue of dried blood stains his hands. He sees you.
If you're looking for healing or the like, then you'd best look elsewhere. My plate is full for now.
The man chomps on the bit of his pipe, generating a small cloud of nervous smoke. Finally, he...
I came by a new patient, a young woman, very troubled. I'll do what I can for her, but I'll need...
He gestures with his pipe for you to leave.
I'm still trying to figure that out. She seems afflicted with... I had no choice but to lock her in Miss Cellar. For her safety and my own. This isn't someone with a broken leg who needs to be held still. This is serious. And... the answer is no. Now, Lee. Can't tell anyone. The magisters would probably have her killed.
A man paces back.
If you're looking for healing or the...
The man chomps.
I came back.
He gestures with his pipe for you to leave.
Oh, fine. You can help. Just be careful. It's clear she's a powerful sorcerer, but... Can't tell anyone. Magisters would probably have her killed. But still powerful. Be careful. Why would someone do this to another person? Be ready to flee if necessary. She's badly afflicted, but still powerful. Be careful. She's badly afflicted, but still powerful. Be careful.
Across the cellar, a shape bearing some resemblance to a woman lurches around to face you. It utters a marrow-curdling gurgle.
She senses us. Be calm and quiet. No, be careful.
Another gurgle, sharper, angrier. Then the sound of rapid footfalls...
the dark with you.
The spirit of a young woman stares down at the remains of her own warped form, aghast. She looks up to you, eyes wide with shock.
What's going on? I was having terrible dreams. There was something crawling about inside of me, making the magisters. They arrested me in arcs. I remember being strapped to a table. They put something in my head. Something alive. I was put on a caravan. Then they said they were bringing me to Fort Joy. That I should be honored to become a pet of the hammer. I remember running away. With blood on my hands, the rest is gone. Someone should try and see what was done to me. Nobody should be left to such a fate. Nobody.
Poor thing. The gods must be in a bath.
He fishes out his pipe and tries to spark it alight with some flint. His trembling hands make it difficult work. He shoves...
To hell with the gods. I'm going to see what I can learn from this poor girl before I give her a proper burial. Maybe it'll help.
The healer is too tired to even muster a scornful expression.
You expect me to believe that?
The healer peers at you for a long moment, then sighs.
It does. She didn't come to me. I found her on a roadside, unconscious. There were shackles around her wrists. The chains sheared right off whatever held her. Leave me to my work now. Maybe I can find something to back... Poor thing. How did this happen to you?
A spillage all over the floor.
Thank you.
What's that? It sounds like there's a battle unfolding nearby.
The shaggy dog keeps his distance, wary eyes sizing you up as his hackles rise.
You run away. Everyone here run away. All run. All run. Something. I knew. All runaways round here. I ran away from bad man. Very bad man. Man wanted to make me spider food. I know. I can sniff good and bad. Riker bad. Bad man. So bad. I liked his house. Big garden of stones. Lots and lots of bones to dig. Good, tasty bones. But when I sniffed him, how he is for true, I ran and ran and ran.
He paws a few tentative steps closer and
smell not like dog, like wolf. But not bad like Riker. Good wolf.
He bounds forwards and licks your face effusively. His breath stinks of graveyard clay and ancient bones. Immediately, you feel an allergic reaction develop. The dog scurries away to sniff about the area, leaving you with his approval and an itchy face.
Looks like this place has seen better days. Much better days. Thank you.
Gareth toils in monotony. Gareth freezes, then turns slowly towards you. His breath sustained.
I'm digging my murdered parents' graves. I'd ask that you show your respects.
Gareth moves to continue his task, but his cadence falters. He pauses. Silence hangs, begging to be broken.
No, of course you didn't,
Godwoken. I've seen Seeker's blood seeping into the sand. I waded through corpses on the deck of the Lady Vengeance. I just didn't know. I didn't know what darkness lied beyond pain. Now, well...
I know the culprits. Dallas's pets. Such helpful tools they are, too. The abominations do the dirty work, and the whites keep their robes clean. They're still there, spreading their rancid smell through the house. Paladins came to clean up the mess. In the name of Lucia...
Gareth shies away from you. His eyes pass over the half-filled graves, and he takes...
I'm the one who has prayed. An endless litany. How many pleas does it take?
Gareth forcefully exhales and looks past you to the nearby house. You fear he might snap the shovel's handle in two.
If you'd asked me yesterday, I'd have said they were the only ones left in the Divine Order worth their... Today, though, I don't know. The Paladins once fought the Black Ring at Lucien's command. The most courageous thing they could do now is turn their backs on the Order. I'm not holding my breath.
I've got no use for empty platitudes. Not from some whinging wolf chosen as...
You swear you hear Gareth's pulse, galloping faster than a saddled mount.
If you want to help, then you find the craven wight that ordered their slaughter. Anyone that stands between you and truth, no matter the flag they fly or creed they follow, make them bleed!
His clenched jaw tightens further, and then, in an instant, Gareth's guard is broken. Tears well in his eyes. With every blink,
My parents... They did nothing to deserve this. I'd give my own life to bring them back. You're right. There's nothing more to be done here. Lucien, forgive me.
The two paladins Gareth mentioned are arguing in front of the door to the modest farmstead. As they notice your arrival, they stop talking and look at you quizzically.
We're guarding this house. Wise to stay well back. There's a bunch of silent monks inside who've tasted blood today.
They didn't kill anybody. The magisters who control them did. You know Donna, she wouldn't hurt a fly. Not until
But they did turn her. And now...
No, wait! Surely... Maybe someday...
The other paladin rolls his eyes and shakes his head as he turns to...
In any event, it's our business, not yours. You just stay well away from the door and you'll be perfectly safe. You can't do that. They were people who were loved. It's not right to butcher them like cattle. Back off, man.
The two paladins Gareth mentioned are arguing in...
We're God! And believe me, you don't want to go in there. There's a bunch of silent...
Lucian's
The two paladins Gareth...
We're God! And believe me, you don't want to go in there. There's a bunch of silent monks inside who've tasted blood today. Already killed in there, so they did. I don't think... Stay out of our business.
The two paladins Gareth meant...
We're God! And believe me, you don't want to go in there. There's a bunch of silent monks inside. I don't think... Stay out of our business.
I can't. That's Donna in there, but she was a friend. Our friend.
That thing isn't Donna. It isn't anybody. It's a monster, pure and simple. All of them are. That creature. It's not Donna, not anymore. It's the Magister's property. Let them handle it. Back off.
The silent monk looks like she was only recently converted. Her face was clearly beautiful once, and the eyes looking at you... One of her hands trembles. Twitching, it reaches out to you. Her hand is cold and smooth, like that of a porcelain doll. Jerkily, as her lips part and her mouth moves. Or, slay me. Or did you only hear what you wanted to hear in the whispers of the wind? Her eyes squeeze shut, and her whole body trembles. This dwarven monk hangs his head, as if looking down at his feet. A wretched girl staring down into his face. You realize you were staring into mutilation. He has no eyes. He does not resist in the least. Emaciated of body and spirit, this silent monk stands straight. This must be Donna, the one spoken of by the paladins guarding the door. She gives no indication at all that she has heard you. Her tears flow along with her blood. Yet, even in the moment of death, she does. The lumpen, silent monk stands like a pillar of decay. All of a sudden, like a bellows, he exhales a fetid gust right into your face. The stench of rot shrouds you, coating you in a way you. He looks through your eyes with seeming disinterest as the life ebbs from his body, drop by drop, until he is gone.
Everything. Everything is very dark all of a sudden.
Whoa. Ground's trembling almost as bad as the Lady Vengeance on rough seas. This Magister didn't die by a sword anyway. Something's afoot here.
Ah!
between us and this lunatic!
Bloody shambles, this. My thanks for your help.
He takes a pull from a water canteen, then splashes some over his blood-stained hands.
No, it ain't mine. A sorcerer fugitive was hiding here. Some of the locals were stupid enough to help him. We got a tip-off, but he wasn't. These Voidwoken appeared, thanks to him. It was messy. A lot of the locals didn't make it, and those that did, well, there's a price for helping sorcerers.
Any trace of gratitude for your help against the Voidwoken drains away.
Take my advice and don't say another word. Hear me? Sorcerers brought this plague down on us. They'll all get what they deserve. You can join them if you like. Otherwise, you can shut your trap. What the hell do you think it means?
He pats the pommel of his sword, his hand still tinted with dried blood. Little
damned idiot!
Just when I think this land holds no more
still.
Slain by Voidwoken. Others, perhaps not.
Be grateful that you don't feel the need.
Junk. These people were slain by blades, not Voidwoken. More slaughter. Killed by Voidwoken, who were then killed themselves.
Give you fair warning, stranger. Turn around and get out of here unless you want to end up like this treacherous filth.
He throws a kick into the ribs of a nearby corpse.
Innocent? I lost comrades today thanks to these innocents and their sorcerer friend.
He gestures around at the Voidwoken wrought destruction in the area.
They forced our hand. We've got to do whatever's necessary to hold the rot at bay. Fool, you could have just walked away.
Thank you.
good find.
Please, over here.
Can you untie me? Please. Thank you.
Her tear-stained cheeks quiver as she surveys the blood.
It's like a bad nightmare. Except...
The young man grunts as he fruitlessly tries to free his hands from the heavy knotted rope.
Thanks.
He looks to his slain brother's body, his eyes well with...
We didn't deserve this.
But please...
The grieving mother manages a thin smile, even as tears streak...
Thank you, stranger.
She blinks out more tears, then rubs them away with the back of her...
To lose a child. It's a mother's worst fear. It's true. What the Magister said, I mean. My brother, he's got source in him. Now that his folks are gone, we've all he's got. He's been staying with us. We thought we could keep... He's not got a spot of malice. He can't help who he is. But when the Magisters came snooping, he panicked. We all did.
She glances at the Magister corpse and shivers. Another tear drips down her...
Shouldn't have let that Hanag woman near Gid. She said she could teach him. But that's when all the... Lizard lady, impeccable robes, came by here one day saying she could sense the source. She could help Gid, she said. He took to her right away. Soon, the Voidwoken came. And then the Magister started knocking. As soon as the Magister fell, Gid knew what he'd done. He didn't even struggle when they dragged him away. God, I've already lost more than I can bear today. I pray to the Seven I haven't lost him to. You will?
She ekes out another thin smile.
Make sure he's safe. And if you can, bring him back to me.
Kin, you speak to Cure.
hatched from the egg of Zora. It pleases Cure to speak to lizards once more. But why does a dragonkin leave the ancient empire?
You stare in shock. It's speaking perfect old tongue. You'd have no idea what it was saying if you weren't well-versed in the Empire's ancient texts.
The elf has many visitors, all manner of ape, but Cure never has the Empire fallen so far. The old master would never have allowed such folly. Cure's old master taught Cure. Consul Zara esteemed lizard until the elf killed Consul.
The lizard lets out a low, rumbling hiss.
Killed Zara for gold. Then he stole Zara's chest and stole Cure away.
The lizard's tongue flickers, a wry grin spreading across its snout.
The elf could not open it. Its magic was beyond the creature and burns still. My master's magic is powerful and it will never fail.
The lizard's eyes, cold, search your face for a moment.
Cure has hoped to keep his master's secrets until the end of time. If you can douse the fire, good prince, sing these words. The chest will open for you like a cracked egg. Honor the memory of Cure's master.
The lizard hisses dismissively.
All apes look alike. They dress in black, but come in all shapes. Tall humans, stunted dwarves. All that is known is they arrived with gold and left with the promise that people will...
With a quiet click, the lid of the chest swings open. Thank you.
could they?
Didn't deserve this.
Gods, have mercy on us. All of them!
You didn't deserve this. Sweet son.
God.
sweet son.
He turns towards you, then he breathes deeply through his nose, his tongue extended, as if he were tasting the air.
Since when does Raiden hire mercenaries? The sorcerer is trapped in the cellar beneath the house. He's dropped one magister, but he won't drop another. We don't need you, Merc. These papers say you're an inquisitor. You don't look like an inquisitor. You don't smell like an inquisitor.
He calmly meets your gaze.
Oh, you smell bad, Merc. But it's all yours. If you ask me, the sorcerer's already dead. But go ahead, you be my guest. First, you'll have to put the fire... Stand back, lads! The Merc's here's gonna show us how it's done. He's gonna bring the sorcerer out unarmed! Because between you and me, if he comes out here armed...
The thought occurs. The Magisters have strayed from the path of Lucian.
That's what happens when you give any few people too much power. Go straight to their heads.
The louder people shout in a god's name, the duller becomes their understanding of its message.
Their dedication to their cause is almost admirable. If one could...
Stand back there!
The man brandishes a sword, ready to fight. A curious weapon, simple but weighty. It seems out of place in the hands of a simple worker, if that's what he is. You have your doubts, for the sword exudes an evil power.
Back, Magister, or I'll cut your guts for ribbons like I did the last fella.
He eyes you up and down, measuring your worth.
All right. I'll go outside, but I won't go unarmed. And I'll take your weapon too, if it's available. What do you say? Can I count on your help? Lead on. Stand back there!
My, my, you did it, Merc. You brought us the sorcerer. And, oh, does he stink?
No sorcerer.
Time to die, sorcerer.
But you said...
It doesn't matter what he said. I am the authority here.
Little help here!
He breathes a sigh of relief.
Let's get him!
Never trust a mercenary.
Thank you.
Was my father's house.
He sighs.
Well. Nothing left for me here.
If he were the crying type, he'd shed a tear, but that doesn't seem...
Thank you.
to none. Need to get clever with this lock.
junk.